My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. O God, you are my God, and I will always praise you. In the shadow of your wings I cling to you, and you hold me high. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. Through the day you walk with me, all the night your love surrounds me. To the glory of your name I lift my hands, I sing your praise. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God.
Let us begin this celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, today we come to celebrate the first Sunday of the Lent. Here we have the temptation of our Lord Jesus, by which he reminds each one of us, as the letter to the Hebrews speaks, for we do not have an high priest who is unable to sympathize with us. One was tempted in all the way possible, but without sin. So we can approach the throne of his glory, that he may bestow upon us grace when we are tempted, when we fall into sin. And as we come before the Eucharistic table, let us thank the Lord for his mercy and love. Let us ask him pardon for those moments where we have been tempted and we have fallen into sin.
Christe eleison, Christe
Almighty and merciful God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "The priest shall receive the basket from you and shall set it in front of the altar of the Lord your God. Then you shall declare before the Lord your God, 'My father was a wandering Aramean who went down to Egypt with a small household and lived there as an alien. But there he became a nation, great, strong, and numerous. When the Egyptians maltreated and oppressed us, imposing hard labor upon us, we cried to the Lord, the God of our fathers, and he heard our cry and saw our affliction, our toil, in our oppression. He brought us out of Egypt with his strong hand and outstretched arms, with terrifying power, with signs and wonders, and bringing us into this country. He gave us this land flowing with milk and honey. Therefore, I have now brought you the first fruits of the products of the soil, which you, O Lord, have given me, and having set them before the Lord your God, you shall bow down in his presence.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble. Be with me, Lord, I pray. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble. Be with me, Lord, I pray. You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord Most High, who abide in the shadow of our God, say to the Lord, my refuge and fortress, the God in whom I trust. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble. Be with me, Lord, I pray. No evil shall befall you, no pain come near, for the angels stand close by your side, guarding you always and bearing you gently, watching over your life. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble. Be with me, Lord, I pray. Those who cling to the Lord live secure in God's love. Lifted high those who trust in God's name. Call on the Lord who will never forsake you. God will bring you salvation and joy. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble. Be with me, Lord, I pray.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what does Scripture say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. For if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart, and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth, and so is saved. For the Scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all, enriching all who call upon him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. The word of the Lord.
Praise and honor to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Praise and honor to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. One does not live on bread alone, comes from the mouth of God. Praise and honor to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you.
Filled with the Holy Spirit, Jesus returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the desert for 40 days to be tempted by the devil. Yet nothing during those days. And when they were over, he was hungry. The devil said to him, if you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread. Jesus answered him, it is written, one does not live on bread alone. Then he took him up and showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a single instant. The devil said to him, I shall give it to you, all this power and glory, for it has been handed over to me, and I may give it to whomever I wish. All this will be yours if you worship me. Jesus said to him in reply, it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him alone shall you serve. Then he led him to Jerusalem, made him stand on the parapet of the temple and said to him, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to guard you, and with their hands they will support you, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Jesus said to him in reply, It is also says, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. When the devil had finished every temptation, he departed from him for a time. The Gospel of the Lord. Brothers and sisters in Christ, Lent is a wonderful time set aside for each one of us to introspect and to come ever more closer to the Lord. When winter comes to the southern pole, the so-called polar night begins. The sun disappears. It does not rise for 4.5 months. It is same. It's all night to 24 hours. Into such a place, an explorer called Richard Byrd goes. And he wants to spend these 4.5 months alone in the South Pole during that severe winter. And it is during that winter time, it goes minus 122 Fahrenheit. And it remains the same for 4.5 months. Richard wants to spend this time alone by himself. He says, you would get up each day 3 times, come out of his house, the small house where he lived in South Pole. 3 times he would open the door, shovel the snow, go out and record the weather. Come back inside, completely dark. Why did he go? Why he want to be there? Why did he spend such a time, 4.5 months, all by himself, in this lonely darkness? In his book Alone, he says, I want to be away from everything. Secondly, wanted to have some serious time for myself. Away from the manly laws. Only listen to the nature, the wind, the cold, the snow. Just to be part of God's nature. Away from all the material possession that would always draw me to be with. He spent 4.5 months. After the first month, he says, there's a remarkable good experience I had when I spent all by myself in the South Pole. The first month itself, I realized, live deeply and profoundly with God and Him alone. Secondly, be simple as possible. Thirdly, I realized I can do away with all the material things I used to long for in our daily living. I can live without them, without man's law. He says, he spent this 4.5 months, now it is already 4 years past. Now come back to this earthly living with the people, and he says, the civilization has not altered my life that I lived alone in the South Pole. That I can be very simple, live a life of simplicity. Also, I can be having such an enormous amount of peace in my life. Not only this wretched Pharaoh has lived such a life. If you look into the Old Testaments and the New Testaments, we have so many wonderful people who led such a way of life. Moses spent 40 days, 40 nights on Mount Sinai. Prophet Elijah spent the same 40 days and 40 nights. John the Baptist spent so many days in the wilderness all by himself. In today's gospel, we have Jesus our Lord who spent 40 days, 40 nights in the wilderness, all by himself. But there is something remarkable about Jesus Christ our Lord. All the other people whom I mentioned, they were never tempted. But Jesus was tempted. Now the question is, why did God allow Jesus to be tempted? What was the purpose of Jesus' temptation in this desert? So many scholars try to understand why God led Jesus to be tempted by the devil. What was the hidden purpose of Jesus' temptation? And they come to two important conclusions. The one is, it leads us insight into the mind and the heart of Jesus Christ our Lord that we otherwise overlook. The first temptations, the gospel tells us that it came about when Jesus was feeling tired and hungry. It would have been so easy for him to ease his divine power to turn stone into bread and take away that hunger. But Jesus refused to use his power for his own benefit or for comfort. This reveals something beautiful about Jesus. It shows us that he was a person who did not let his body dictate to his spirit. He did not let his feeling influence his action. He lived totally led by the Spirit, totally led by the Spirit. Never his emotion or his feelings to dictate what he must do. When you look later on at the end of the mission of our Lord Jesus, when he goes to the Garden of Gethsemane, there, the whole body is inclined to be led by his body. And he was sweating blood. The fear is overtaken upon him. The emotion is trying to overpower him. At that moment, he cries to the Lord, "Lord, if possible, let this cup pass from me." But then he realized he must not allow his body to dictate terms to him. Then he says, "Not my will, Lord, let your will be done." This is the beautiful thing about our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus was the kind of person who did not let his body dictate to his spirit. He did not let his feelings to influence his action. And that is the primary thing we need to learn from our Lord Jesus Christ. Many a times in our lives, we are all driven by our emotion. We want the external things to influence us. We are carried away by the wind of the desires of the world. But during this season of Lent, the very first Sunday, teaching each one of us, don't be carried away by the desires of the world. Don't allow the emotions to rule over you. Don't allow anything of this world to take you away from the purpose for which God has created you and me. We all need to be led by the Spirit of God to allow ourselves detached by the temptations of this world. There are something attractive about many people in the world today, especially when you look into the youngsters, some youngsters. They can resist the desires of this world. In Chicago, an high school boy who was part of a wrestling team. In the wrestling team, they must maintain their body weight. But this particular boy, contrary to the wrestling team, he was putting on weight. You know, today in our world, everyone wants McDonald's and Burger King. And this man was also tempted to this McDonald's and Burger King. But then he knew if he goes this way, his team will be thrown out of these wrestling matches. He makes a firm decision, not for one day, 2 days, one full year. You know, when we come out of your rugby field or your wrestling team, any golf ground, you want immediately go to McDonald's or Burger King, and especially youngsters. This young boy resisted. He restrained from eating Burger King and McDonald's. At times, his parents were frightened. Will this lead him to die? But the resistance was such an enormous that the Spirit allowed him to overcome everything. And he was able to make this sacrifice for the sake of his team, for the sake of the purpose for which he was motivating his spirit to lead him. Similar way, in Italy, there was a very famous musician, Arturo Toscanini. As a young man, he goes to music school to study music. But he comes from a very poor family. In the music school, every day you need to buy new music notes to buy study or to buy heart. It seems this Arturo Toscanini would sacrifice his meat, sell his meat to his companions so that he can buy the music notes and study. End of his music course, he has by-hearted every music that he wanted to study. Because of the sacrifice that he made at every meal, he sold the meat that was placed on his plate to his companions, bought the music notes and studied. That is where these young men teach each one of us how we can resist temptations. How we can resist the temptations of the flesh. And they also teach us, no sacrifice is too great for them. There is no challenge too demanding for them. And there is no dreams that is impossible to achieve. Today, as we come to celebrate the first Sunday of the Lent, the Lord is trying to teach each one of us. We need to be aware. The emotions, the actions of our body or flesh should not dictate terms to us. We must always allow the Spirit to lead us in the right direction so that we come at the end of this Lenten season to rise with Christ Jesus our Lord. The second important point is very brief indeed. In this temptation of our Lord, he resisted. He never fell into temptation, which is also teaching through Jesus into our lives. That he comes to share with our human nature, where he says, when we are tempted, we have an high priest, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is able to sympathize with us. He goes through the temptations
so that he can understand our weakness. So beautiful indeed. God the Father allows Jesus Christ our Lord to be tempted, who overcame the temptation so that he can understand the overwhelming temptation that you and I go through each day, so that he will not condemn us, but he will be sympathetic towards each one of us. He will show his compassion upon each one of us. Brothers and sisters, that is the beautiful way Jesus is coming to share our humanity. He's not sinning, but he's understanding how we fall into sin. He's not condemning us, he's coming to restore us when we fall into sin. That is why the letter to the Hebrews, the author is telling us, we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weakness, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of his glory to receive mercy and to find grace in timely help. Brothers and sisters, as we have begun the season of Lent, let us remember Jesus never allowed the temptation to dictate terms to him. And secondly, Jesus is there to sympathize with our human weakness. He will restore us, provided we allow the Spirit of the Lord to lead each one of us. Amen. Let's all join together and profess our faith. Visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, as we begin the season of Lent, let us present to the Lord all our prayers and petitions.
For the needs of the Universal Church, St. Patrick Parish, and in particular for Mary English on the 4th anniversary of her death, and for the health of Billy Reed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all church leaders, may the example of Jesus inspire them in humble service of love for God's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hold public office, may God grant them strength, compassion, and wisdom in their duties. Let us pray to the Lord. For those persecuted for their faith, may the Holy Spirit bless them with fortitude. Let us pray to the Lord. For the faith community, may the love of Christ inspire us to share his love with our neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, may Jesus welcome them to the great wedding feast of the Lamb. Let us pray to the Lord. For the homebound, that they may be healed by the loving touch of the Lord, and that all their prayers will be answered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, you said, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. In faith we have done so. May you provide what is needful for us. This prayer we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So to wear the crown to bear his cross, so to wear the crown he wore. I will run the race, I will fight the good fight, so to win the prize of the kingdom. Only this I want, but to know the Lord and to bear his cross, so to wear the crown he wore.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Give us the right disposition, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance. And by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, they might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. So, and so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Alan our Archbishop, all the assisting bishops, the order of bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, his spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints, Saint Patrick, Saint Vincent Pilate, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours
forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the peace of Christ.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us everlasting life.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you, lest you dash your foot against the stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. Hold you in the palm of his hand.
The Memorare. Remember, most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone would fly to thy protection, implore thy help, so then intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions. In thy mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed now with the heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished and hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
Our final hymn is number 605. Blessed be the Lord.
Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark night, nor the arrow that flies by day. He will release me from the nets of all my foes. He will protect me from their wicked hands. Beneath the shadow of his wings I will rejoice, to find a dwelling place secure. Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day. I need not not shrink before the terrors of the night, nor stand alone before the light of day. No harm shall come to me, no arrow strike me down, no evil settle in my soul. Bless me the Lord, bless me the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves, I shall not fear.